red light.
Okay, now I'm getting some. Well,
I think it has rained since we came down here.
Yeah. This road wasn't this wet.
This is the second one.
Thank you. They don't keep our interstates in good shape, sleeping.
No, they sure don't.
That's amazing. You just broke your one of trees right there.
Yeah.
Right in the middle. right there.
Steady.
That one I don't think suffered like this other one down here did.
Thank you. traffic coming right there.
Yeah, a lot of keys and a lot of locks within them.
Except for the cameras that are on charge.
Take them off.
Watch south, the boy's funeral's coming through. I've never seen as many patrol cars in my life. Watch when they come down the hill, it's touching. Gee, weird.
They just keep coming though.
Yeah.
I didn't know I also had that many police.
I didn't either. I wonder who's taking care of the city.
The sheriff's department, I guess.
Probably.
And most of them's got two people in the front and a couple in the back. You know it?
Man, that's the way it ought to be.
You got that right. Last time I saw something like this, I wasn't there, but I saw a video that you shot when that trooper got killed back in 92 or 91.
Yeah.
I don't know who it was, but I remember they had a funeral.
I wish you could see out this mirror, man. Blue lights as far as you can see from both sides of the roads. Where in the world would they park all the people at the funeral?
Where are they having the funeral at?
Higgins.
That can't even happen. They're standing there.
They can't get this many people.
That's a testament to that boy's life, you know? That's a testament to that boy's life. His death.
For a man that young, it is. His wife was an EMT, that's the reason all ambulances.
Still down there, Daddy. They still got a long
time. I know. That's awesome. What a testament. What a testament.
People think the pole down is something important, but I tell you, to me, it ain't nothing compared to somebody down like he did or for what he stood for, you know?
Thank you.
Yes. Glad you heard this time. Here, now you want a little picture, you go take a picture of that little dog in there that we got out of New Orleans on Wednesday.
Brother, what's the ticket? Settled, the storm surge is above it. The storm surge probably went over the top.
Now, this is after the bridge, this is after the initial cleanup. This is what they're terming the final cleanup. So you can imagine how bad the initial was. These boats came from the marina. That's in that blue apartment complex up ahead. It's probably half a mile. And they came over the top of them. Because you can't get around them. Here, that's a barge.
Sergeant Lancaster with the National Guard that's at the bridge. I was just advised by somebody that he sat down here and he's calling out because the Corps is near the God Lake with him or some kind of deal like that.
I'm kind of numb to it now. I cried my first day. I've seen all the you can come home, baby. There is nothing here. Your house is gone. I mean, you don't have a house. It's not there.
She wants to come home because she needs closure.
Yeah. I'll mail her a picture.
See you. Yeah. I said, I'll mail you a picture. There's no electricity. There's no nothing here. Go ahead, Sergeant. Now I got gas in decent.
Sir, is that a clear path all the way through? We're trying to reach that hotel.
Starting to sink now. The whole canal is full on Wednesday, as far as you can see. That's a house I'm sitting right there that comes from that subdivision behind it. From the other side of the canal to your right as you're looking at it, across the canal and across the road. I still haven't figured out where that thing comes from. That's part of somebody's house, but I don't know where it comes from.
Everybody's real nice here tonight. I like the, you know, the good time. Go ahead.
It's open.
Lock it off. Actually, go to the other end with whoever's with you, and there's no traffic allowed on the bridge to enter. They're already in. We're kind of stuck with that. Go on to the south shore right there at the entrance to the bridge and lock it off at that point. Make sure you let the DOT and the railroad know you're there so they'll let you know before they reopen. It looks like you just picked it up in the sky and dropped it, huh? Mm-hmm. We think the two people stayed in that one. Obviously, we're not going to be able to come up with that.
Probably ever find
them. Yeah, they may be in there. We may find them during demolition. There was a guy that stayed in here. We found him about 4 miles inland. Sitting on somebody else's roof. Kind of serves as a dumbass ride, I think.
And all these were houses over here.
All these.
These posts were over here.
Yep, every one of them.
so damp and moist, and just everything out here is nasty.
Well, that's when we brought you that bleach. We figured, you know, you could dilute it in water.
Everything's so nasty. And there's no sewage out here. The sewage people thought we had overflowed. Some of them got a sense of humor. Yeah. Did you get it on film?
Yeah, dirt cheap, picture upper, waterfront.
Yeah, and most of these people, I'm telling you, are taking it so much better than you would think they will be on. Most of them are taking it right. We've had, from the residents, we've only had just an isolated amount of problems. You know, but they're constructive.
Do I have to?
okay, huh?
Sure does.
Come see, gentlemen. I used to say I was scared to death in a fire. I take a fire over a flood. When I came in here on, I think it was Thursday, the water was up to the bushes. I had to walk the water to get in. That's not a lake.
That's part of the golf course.
Sheriff's office!
On behalf of the St. Tammany Parish Sheriff's Office and its citizens, we'd like to thank Lincoln County, Tennessee, and especially the Misfit Motorcycle Club for your support. These guys from the Motorcycle Club have been down here with us twice now this week. They brought us much needed supplies. We've needed water, we've needed ice, we've needed cleaning supplies. They've come through with us without any asking. We've never met y'all before. We love you, we appreciate you. If you look at some of the footage that we've taken during the short tour that we've taken this morning, you can see everything down here is destroyed. We have no place for our citizens to live that are still here. We have no place for our evacuees to come home to. We're all without water, we're without sewage, we're without electricity, we're without any type of gas at all, natural gas, gasoline for our vehicles and short supply. We don't have a grocery store open in this parish. We don't have a pharmacy. Our hospitals are on emergency generators and they're running out of fuel. We have people dying left and right for lack of provisions. Y'all have been a great help to us. We've talked to the guys that came down to Andy and Drew and told them what we needed and what we could really use. If there's any law enforcement that could support us, our guys are working 16-hour days, are on 7 days a week so far. There's no relief for us in sight. Our rescue operations guys, I think we're at about 15% of our parish at this point, has been covered and cleared. We'd have to do a house-by-house search for survivors. We don't know who stayed and who didn't. The storm came upon us in such a way that there was no way we could get in and see who was here before the storm came. The area where we're standing on Monday morning probably had 14 feet of water in the street where I'm standing right now. Some of the houses that we've gone through, especially this one right here to my right, the last one on your video, the little blue brick house, it appears perfectly fine on the outside with maybe some missing shingles. Look at the inside of that house. That house has 4 feet of water on the inside. We showed you the water line on the tape. The floors are about an inch and a half of mud on them. They're white tile floors, just to give you some kind of indication of what's going on. We're looking for any kind of support that y'all can give us. We desperately need any type of clothing for our citizens. These people have lost everything, y'all. There's no houses standing where there's houses. There's apartment buildings and complexes and commercial buildings that are completely gone. You can see the slabs where they used to be. Anything that you can do to help us, we'd sure appreciate. We support you. Anything that we can ever do in kind, I promise you we'll be there. We've gone across the whole state and the South and helping people in their time of need and their disasters. We're begging. We're absolutely begging for help. If anybody has happened to see the Red Cross anywhere in Tennessee or in Arkansas, Wyoming, wherever, ask them if they would mind coming down here and looking for us. We keep hearing about them, but I tell you that we haven't seen a one of y'all yet. If you got any connections with the federal government, I have 21 National Guard troops in this whole parish. This parish is 884 square miles. Our population is between 240 and 250,000 people. Of the 21 troops that I have, three of them are armed. We have looters, we have thefts, we're starting to have maybe a civil disturbance would be a better word. All our citizens that are remaining, y'all, have not eaten, they have no water, they have no place to stay.
We're standing in the sun right now. It's about, well, it's exactly 12:05. It's near about 100 degrees out here with 90% humidity. Anything y'all can give us, we appreciate. These guys know exactly what we need. All your help is really needed. Anything that you can do for us, we're really looking for. Law enforcement, again, we're pleading for your help. If you can come down and give us a couple of days at a time, a day at a time, two people at a time, we could use it. We need it. We're looking for our guys to go home and take care of their families for at least a day or so. 70% of our department of 700 people have lost everything that they own. I'm talking houses, cars, their children's clothing, pictures. They have nothing. We're all sleeping in our cars. We're sleeping in tents. We're sleeping in condemned buildings. You know, our sheriff and the public are doing the best that they can for everybody. The fact is that we just have nothing to go to. Again, on behalf of the citizens of St. Tammany Parish, please send us what you can. We're begging for your help. Hey, anybody from Red Cross listening, give us a call. Come see what we got. Thank you.
If anybody is hurt and aware, they can get his check. It's supposed to be to it Monday. And of course, he didn't get it. But he's got money there and he needs it.
I can understand that completely. It's going to be difficult to move around without money, of course. Now, while I'm saying this, I'm thumbing through this paper again here because I believe we've got something in the phone around here somewhere.
Yeah, I didn't hear that, but I'm not sure what.
Yes, we've got no less than about 5 pounds of paper running around here. Troy Anderson, the case of federal credit union is not open today. But at least it's all typed now. Last time I was here, handwriting was just the line.
Well, what if we do this? What if we let her go and we'll find it as I'll look for it while you're talking to other callers and I'll try to find it for you. We'll put it on the air for you.
Sure, you certainly can.
Hi, Dr. Radliff, a veterinarian in Wiggins, I use it myself, just called and said that he will be emergencies only. He has an emergency telephone number. This is for emergencies only, no shots or anything like that, something that can wait. Same with WXXP's town.
There you go.
Yeah, so there you go. We're all in this together, so.
Well, you need to talk about a big disaster. He got those two together.
Exactly. WXXP will be hosting WLOX's signal in about 15 minutes from here.
Yay.
Looking forward to it.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate that.
Appreciate that a lot. Yeah.
I will say before we get to the phone call, we have got this storm has told me a lot about the character of my neighbors.
Yeah, it really has. It's been
the character of everybody. I can't believe exactly.
All right, let's get back to the phone lines and see what else we got here. Hi, this is Kicker 108, and we've got you on the air. Talk to